BOHICA, 12,128 gold contracts dumped in 1 minute. Here it comes again. And again. This time it is coming harder and faster after the initial dump this morning. Here is another, just a little reminder about how this works. Nobody in their right mind would come in and all of the sudden have to sell 12,128 contracts. Damn the price. That's over $1.5 billion in gold sold in one single minute. Sure, this is not to say every contract sold that minute was from one person. What it means is that a huge order comes in. It hits everybody's bid, and then some. This causes traders who are long, betting the price will rise, to sell out of their positions because they are losing money. For example, person buys gold this morning at $1,293. They set up a stop loss at $1,280. This means they are willing to lose $13 on the trade and sell automatically to get out of it so they don't lose any more. A huge order comes in at 11:37 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, which is just what happened. The order blows the $1,280 to the downside, so the trader is sold out of his position. Now multiply this by 100s and 100s of traders that are in the market setting stop losses to not lose that much money. When the banks flood the sell orders, the longs losing money are forced to sell out of their positions. Others legitimately trying to sell must sell at a lower price, because there is a massive order dropping that price. The banks, on the other hand, just sold all that gold. They didn't have any gold. They sold it short, meaning they sold it first, and have to buy it back later. If they buy it back later at a lower price, they make money. They sold it for $1,293 and bought it from our trader above at $1,280. The bank made $13. Our trader lost $13, and since the trader does not have unlimited money, but because the banks can sell unlimited paper gold to push down the price, the bank wins. The time when it stops is when there is no gold left on the COMEX to deliver. That is the point when the manipulation is up. Until then, the banks can always strong-arm the individual, because the banks print the money and the paper gold. But there is indeed a limit to selling short because actual gold has to be delivered. The other thing forcing a floor, where the price can't go lower, is the cost of production. Printing paper gold is free, but mining the real thing costs money, so they can't push too far. It is a delicate balance, but it works, and will work until it won't, and that is when we see perhaps commercial signal failure, which is when they sold too much gold and can't deliver it all. Here is another look at the morning massacre, BOHICA, just in the time it took to type this up. To all the Bitcoin fans, welcome to your first lesson in market manipulation and price suppression 101. Except real physical gold and silver is very expensive to mine and must be delivered into the market, so the real thing backstops hold it short, meaning they sold it first and have to buy it back later. If they buy it back later at a lower price, they make money. They sold it for $1,293 and bought it from our trader above at $1,280. The bank made $13. Our trader lost $13. And since the trader does not have unlimited money, but because the banks can sell unlimited paper gold to push down the price, the bank wins. The time when it stops is when there is no gold left on the COMEX to deliver. That is the point when the manipulation is up. BOHICA, 12,128 gold contracts dumped in 1 minute. Here it comes again. And again. This time it is coming harder and faster after the initial dump this morning. Here is another, just a little reminder about how this works. Nobody in their right mind would come in and all of the sudden have to sell 12,128 contracts. Damn the price. That's over $1.5 billion in gold sold in one single minute. Sure, this is not a standard time, which is just what happened. The order blows though $1,280 to the downside, so the trader is sold out of his position. Now multiply this by 100s and 100s of traders that are in the market setting stop losses to not lose that much money. When the banks flood the sell orders, the longs losing money are forced to sell out of their positions. Others legitimately trying to sell must sell at a lower price, because there is a massive order dropping that price. The banks, on the other hand, just sold all that gold. They didn't have any gold. They sold, say, every contract sold that minute was from one person. What it means is that a huge order comes in. It hits everybody's bid, and then some. This causes traders who are long, betting the price will rise, to sell out of their positions, because they are losing money. For example, person buys gold this morning at $1,293. They set up a stop loss at $1,280. This means they are willing to lose $13 on the trade and sell automatically to get out of it so they don't lose any more. A huge order comes in at 11:37 a.m. Eastern. Till then, the banks can always strong-arm the individual, because the banks print the money and the paper gold. But there is indeed a limit to selling short, because actual gold has to be delivered. The other thing forcing a floor, where the price can't go lower, is the cost of production. Printing paper gold is free, but mining the real thing costs money, so they can't push too far. It's a delicate balance, but it works, and will work until it won't. And that is when we see perhaps commercial signal failure, which is when they sold too much gold and can't deliver it all. He read.